Welcome back everyone. So in this video, let's talk about the function prototype. So we will create a function. We will create the function object using constructor function like new person. So whenever you use a new keyword and the function name, that is called the constructor function. I mean, we are creating the object of the function using constructor. Okay, so this is the person and I have added some prototype properties in a function. So if you see, I want to open the diagram. Okay, so consider a scenario. So here I am doing a person, and now if I do console.dir, the person object, person function. Okay, what will I get? This is just a description about the person function, right? So okay, it's not able to print the function, but this person function will have all these prototype properties in it. Okay, and what all those prototype properties will be? Name, is, friends, and CNAME method, right? Now I'm creating two objects of that function using constructor function, person one and person two. So let's try to visualize this, how the things are happening. So this is my function. Let's consider it's a human function or person function, right? So this is the person function. Okay, I'm creating, so this is the person human function, and we are creating the constructor property, right? So this function has all the prototype properties, name, age, or whatever the methods we have defined, and this is the prototype object we have created. Okay, now let's talk about, we are creating the objects of this human object or person object, right? So how it will look like? This look like this. So we are creating person one from the human object, person one human object. Okay, what we are doing, the proto of this object, person one and person two are object, and human is just another function. Let's forget about the code. Human is a function. Now we are creating person one and person two. These are the two objects from the constructor function property of human. So when you do a new human, we are creating person one. When you are doing new human, we are creating person two. So this is the final picture, right? So I'm creating the two new human object with name person one and person two, right? So the proto of both the objects will point to the prototype of human function, human.prototype. Okay. And further, if you talk about the human prototype, it will point to the object prototype. Human prototype underscore proto, it will point to the object prototype, which further, whose proto will point to null. Okay, so you can change this function to human or person, whatever the name it is. This is like human, and here we have all these different prototype properties onto the human. Okay, and we created two object for the human. Okay, now what is happening is you have the person one and person two, right? So I'm changing, I'm updating the property of person one friends, and I'm adding the Amit property into the person one object. So because you are actually updating on the person one object, so it will also get reflected in the person two, because these friend, name, age, all are prototype property which are shared among all the objects. So whatever you do, if you are changing the name for person one, this will reflect for the person two. If you are changing the age for person one, it will reflect for person two. That is the, you can say, disadvantage, or this is how the prototype works, because prototypes are shared among all the objects. This is a single copy. So if you push Amit into the names array, now the names array will be all these three names, right? Person one and person two both points to the same friends array of the prototype object. So if person one modifies the friends property, then obviously it's going to be updated for all the objects. Okay, so this is the first initial step to understand the prototype of a function. You create a function, you create a constructor property, you create an object. But before that, you can create the prototype properties. It can just a single property, it can be a simple function, it can be a variable like name, age, and friends. These are just primitive types, and here we are adding the function. Okay, so in the next video we will try to remove this disadvantage that whenever you are changing the prototype property of one object, it's impacting the others. How can we fix it in the next video?